in that general manner, because the sin debt has been paid on. And I don't know about you, but I'm glad about it. Amen. We are certainly grateful that we have been afforded this privilege, for we realize that it was not of our own goodness nor the might of our works, but God has allowed us to be here tonight. To let me know the distance that I made, I would like to excuse all those folks that just came to say, let's be
lonely.
I'm afraid none of them sat here at the front. Amen. Because if you came just to get it over with, see, before you decide what you say, what if Christ had said, let's just get it over with? Huh? What if when you were sick, if he hadn't said, let's just get it over with? What if when you was about to leave your house, if he hadn't said, let's just get over with? Amen? What about when your children were acting right? What if he hadn't said, let's just get over with? for being so kind to come and share with us.
Amen.
I'm not worthy to stand here. But by the grace and the mercy of God,
Amen.
I am what I am.
Amen.
I thank God.
Yes.
For I realize that God is not through with me.
Amen.
I want to call again your attention to me. Push the scripture found in the gospel according to St. John. The 17th chapter. You know that the 17th chapter of John is prayer that our Lord prayed. And when we would look at the first verse, we would find these words. Jesus spoke these words. Lifted up his eyes to heaven and said, Father, the hour has come. Glorify your Son, that your Son also may glorify you. I want to talk from you all over the subject. Jesus at his death.
All right.
Jesus at his death. Let us pray. Gracious God, our Heavenly Father. Lord God, it's a day that we come with thanksgiving in our hearts. Lord God, we are thankful that you have given us yet another opportunity to stand and proclaim your word as the true and the living God.
Yes, Lord.
I pray now, Lord, that the word of my mouth and the meditation of the countenance of our heart will be acceptable in thy sight. In the name of Jesus, we do pray. We ask it all. Amen.
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 And amen.
Amen.
God has some unusual ways sometimes of working out what he wants us to say, what he wants us to do. Do y'all agree with that?
Amen.
I was watching the NCAA basketball game, Georgetown, little college out of Florida, Florida Central. Everybody knew that Georgetown was going to win the game. Nobody even expected them to come close. One of the players in an interview after the game, just when they asked him how they were able to overcome, he simply said that we did our best. A few days before that, the New Orleans Hornets. Amen.
Amen.
Had the Miami Heat down 30-some-odd points. Seemed like the streak was going to end at 22. Y'all know LeBron went off. They tried to talk him into talking about himself. They said to him, "You really took care of business." He said, "I did my best." Then beginning on last Thursday, Arnold Palmer, Invitational. By the end of the second round on Friday, Tiger Woods was about 4 strokes back. And by Saturday, he had taken a 2-shot lead.
Come on in.
They didn't get to play Sunday because the Lord didn't want to pay them. So they finished up Monday. I don't know how many of you like Tiger like I do. Tiger had dropped to the 58th player in the world. When Monday came to a close, he was once again number one in the world. During the interview on Monday night, somebody asked Tiger, how was he able? He said, "Well, you know, I simply did my best." What I'm trying to say to the church tonight, it's something to be said when we are able to know in ourselves that we have done our best. See, there are too many opportunities, and there are too many of us that if we would tell the truth, we know that we are not doing a whole lot. But yet and still, we want somebody to believe that we are doing our best. I don't know about you. There have been times in my own life, amen, when I realized that what I did was not enough. I didn't stay on my knees long enough. There's been times in my life, I'm talking about me, I'm not talking about y'all, amen. There have been times in my life, amen, when there was no use in me asking God that he would give me something else to do, when I realized I had not done what he had given me to do already. You see, I want you to know something. If this week is going to be meaningful to us, amen, there are some things in all of us, amen, that we simply need to get fixed. Amen. There's no use going into another year, coming back to another Holy Week service on the Lancaster District a year from now. Amen. And we are still operating under the same assumption. I believe that God is calling us, amen, to do our best. Amen. What if tonight, if everyone in here who has a reason to praise God, if everyone in here who God has made a way for, everybody in here who the devil had counted you out, but God lifted you up, but everybody in here whom God has brought you from the basement to the penthouse, if everybody in here who your doctor had told you you wasn't going to get well, I wonder if all of us had done our best in praising God. This place, you think it's hot in here now? I believe you would have to call God, I'm not a problem here. Amen. And I think sometimes we get so, we come and we go to the Holy Week service, and we go and we come from Palm Sunday, then we go and we come from Easter Sunday morning. I believe we become immune to what God really has done for us. I believe we get to a point in our lives to where it's just a matter of going. I need a witness tonight. I need somebody, amen, that you have a reason to be here. That you have been counted out. Amen. You were sick and the doctor said that you weren't going to get well. Amen. There
there was somebody, amen, in your household that was sick and the doctor had found them out. They were ready to put you out of your house. They were ready to put you out of your car. But Jesus made a way. Can I get a witness tonight? Somebody let truly know that Jesus can and Jesus will make a way. Can't get a witness from here. Maybe I'll call the witness from back yonder somewhere. I believe I could call on one that had an issue of blood for 12 long years who has walked around here tonight. I believe if I asked what happened when Jesus was at his best, I believe he would say, I just touched the hem of his garment and my good God Almighty. Father, we need it. I could call Jairus and say, Jairus, tell me what happened when Jesus was at his best. I believe Jairus would say, my daughter was late. He was on the way to my house. Jesus stopped by and dealt with the woman with an issue of blood. I believe Jairus would say, but Jesus
is headed back. They're watching the disciples.
They listened to his teacher. They listened to him tell them the things that was going to be some things that already worked. And y'all know Jesus told his disciples. He said, right now, you don't know how to act. But he said that there's going to come a time when you are going to be able to ask for some things in my name. And the very things that you ask, my Father in heaven who hears and speaks, he will reward you openly.
The sickness, the voice of God, the call of America, it's been captured.
lifted up.
Uh-huh.
His
eyes.
To the Father.
Uh-huh.
In heaven.
Uh-huh.
He said, Father, the hour is come. In other words, what he's saying, that all that I did on the backside of right now, all that I went through on the back porch of what I'm making. What?
Verse 6. And the third and final point. I have manifested your name to many whom you have given me out of the world. And they were yours. And you gave them to me. And they have kept the word. I believe for my third time that Jesus was at his death because he had an understanding of how things work.
Yeah.
You see, church, some of us have got to not get rest. How this thing
works. All right, preacher.
Most of us in here are in the dark. Some of us think that all I got to do is fight the
pressure.
Some of us act like all I got to do is fight the pressure. As long as I fight the pressure, I come out of the cave. The pastor represents the angel of God. You can't win and fight against God's angel. Jesus understood how things work. How do you know that, preacher? I know that because when it got to the God, the Bible said that he declared, Father, if it's possible, let this cup pass from me, but nevertheless, let not my will come, but let your will be done. You see, he had an understanding of how things work. We got to get an understanding of how the same work. You can't talk about your brother or your sister and expect God to bless you. You can't found the program of God and expect God to move in your personal life. I come by the faith. Jesus was at his best. He had a little bit of time. One final thing. The last thing that he said in chapter 7, Jesus brought. He said, I want you to know this. You got to love. For us hating on one another.
All right, preacher.
Time out for you hating somebody. Because God has blessed them with bigger than what you got. Time out. Put God in mind. Come here, Jairus. Jairus, could you stand there and be so patient, knowing that Jesus should have been on his way to your house, but he stopped somewhere else. I can hear Jairus sing that all